Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
It's lovely to be back here in our sanctuary today. I want to thank you for those that are wearing orange today and for wearing your masks and for following those COVID rules. And yes, and if you would like to come, please reserve your spot before each Sunday, and so we have a place for you. Announcements today. So we are wearing orange in recognition of National Day for Truth and Reconciliation on September the 30th. And on that day, Reverend Takouhi will be at the town park at 2 o'clock, along with others, to celebrate that day. Just a reminder that we are on Facebook and YouTube and Kojiko TV, so that if you don't feel comfortable yet coming here, then please use the other ways of seeing us. I think we have a happy birthday. Yes, happy birthday to Leanne Crawford, and may joy abound and love multiply. And if you have any birthdays or announcements, or anniversaries, you can always call the office and so that we can celebrate your special day. Also, if you have prayers, remember in your prayers all those who are in hospital and recovering at home, and those who may need our comfort and guidance. And you can also notify the office for those people, and so that Reverend Takouhi can go and visit, and we can put them in our prayers. Pies are for sale. The Pies of God's Sake team have been busy this summer and fall, and we'll have 200 delicious pies ready for Thanksgiving. Boy, they've been busy. You can choose your favorites: apple, apple crumble, blueberry, bumbleberry, cherry, peach, raspberry, rhubarb, strawberry, strawberry rhubarb, strawberry rhubarb crumble, and raisin. So there's many varieties there. And all the other information is in the bulletin. Orders can be placed starting Wednesday, September the 29th. Also, Paul Scott has been very busy writing our newsletter, and I hope you received it this week. And if you didn't receive it this week in your email, then please contact the office, because it has lots of great information there.
There's copies in the back.
Oh, there's copies in the back, I hear. So there you go, hard copies. Worldwide Communion is next week, so please come back and celebrate with us. And also, we're going to be recognizing the missing and Indigenous murdered women on October the 4th, so please wear red. I believe that's all the announcements, unless anybody else has anything that needs to be said. Thank you.
Good and blessed morning, everyone, and welcome to this sanctuary where a simple building becomes an extraordinary and a sacred space because of the love that brings us together. We welcome all who are also with us virtually. Doesn't matter where you are part of God's family. We gather to nourish our souls, strengthen our hearts and minds, and be encouraged to go out there and live the mission of God with humbleness and truth. Beloved, life is all about making a difference. Life is not a competition. Life is about loving, caring, and sharing. Making a difference is all about truth and reconciliation. Therefore, with this in mind, we acknowledge all traditional territories, all ceded and unceded lands that we live upon, and give thanks for all the generations of people who have taken care of these lands before us and still do with us today. May we be open to historical truths, and may we continue to learn from the past, shape our present time, and build a better world for all people. Our spiritual focus reminds us today, self-importance builds barriers. God invites us to build bridges. Our call to worship, which comes to us from Psalm 124, tells us, if it had not been for God, who was on our side, we would have fallen prey to those who want to harm us. We would have been swept away by sadness and fear. God has broken the snare that took away our freedom. Our help is in the name of the Lord, who made the heaven and earth. Blessed be God's holy name. Join me as you are able, and let us pray together the prayer of approach that is printed in the order of worship. This prayer comes to us from the book of Esther, where we read about a courageous woman who put her life in danger to save her people. So let us pray together as one family. God of courage, you gave Esther the strength to speak out and the intelligence she needed to save her people. Help us to believe that you are still present and active in this world, and that your grace remains as an everlasting force in our lives. In Jesus Christ we pray. Amen. Beloved, when we gather together every week, we are reminded that our story is God's story. Our story is all about love, the eternal, unchanging love of God. So with that assurance, let us sing together. I know we're all wearing masks. If you want to sing, just sing gently where we are seated. But more than ever, pay attention to the words, because those words remind us that God's love is unchanging. Let us sing.
Thank you.
Thank you, Paul. Truly, Jesus, our teacher and friend, our example to follow, patiently walks with us on this journey and instructs us to how to live a life that matters. Therefore, as pilgrims on a journey seeking the way of Jesus, let us pray together the prayer of illumination as we pursue the wisdom of God. Let us pray as one family. Your word is our salt. Without it, we lose our being, our joy, and our ability to endure. Open our hearts and our minds to listen, to really listen to your word today. Amen. Friends, we hear from the Gospel of Mark. Joan?
Today, we continue the journey with Jesus and the disciples, and we hear from the Gospel of Mark, chapter 9, verses 38 to 50. Let us open our hearts and ears and listen to the word. John said to him, "Teacher, we saw someone casting out demons in your name, and we tried to stop him because he was not following us." But Jesus said, "Do not stop him, for no one who does a deed of power in my name will be able soon afterward to speak evil of me. Whoever is not against us is for us. For truly I tell you, whoever gives you a cup of water to drink because you bear the name of Christ will by no means lose the reward. If any of you put a stumbling block before one of these little ones who believe in me, it would be better for you if a great millstone were hung around your neck and you were thrown into the sea. If your hand causes you to stumble, cut it off. It is better for you to enter life maimed than to have two hands and to go to hell, to the unquenchable fire. And if your foot causes you to stumble, cut it off. It is better for you to enter life lame than to have 2 feet and to be thrown into hell. And if your eye causes you to stumble, tear it out. It is better for you to enter the kingdom of God with one eye than to have 2 eyes and to be thrown into hell, where their worm never dies and the fire is never quenched. For everyone will be salted with fire. Salt is good, but if salt has lost its saltiness, how can you season it? Have salt in yourselves and be at peace with one another. This is the gospel of Jesus Christ. May the Spirit add understanding to our hearing. Amen.
Thank you so much, Joan. I know there's so much we can study from this short passage, but for the sake of time, we're going to only focus on a small portion of it, because you don't want to be here for 5 days. Let us pray. Holy One, may the words of my mouth and the meditation of our hearts and minds come from you and return into this world back for your glory. Teach us once again that following Jesus has nothing to do with our own accomplishments, but it has everything to do with the realm of God that calls us to build bridges of love and respect. Amen. Dearly beloved, if you have been accompanying us in person or virtually for the last 2 weeks, you would have heard that the focus of the Gospel of Mark readings has been about who Jesus is and who we are. If you didn't know, you are a disciple. So who we are, the followers of Jesus. 2 weeks ago, we heard Jesus ask his disciples, "Who do people say that I am?" He wasn't asking this to feed his own ego, but he was asking because when your thoughts affect your actions, right? So when you think about someone, what type of a person that person is, then effectively the way you treat them is the action. But Jesus took one more step and he turned it into more of a personal question by saying, "But who do you say that I am?" Reminding his disciples then and now that how we perceive people plays a big part on how we treat them. And last week, the day before our big Canadian election day, we heard Jesus say to the 12 and to us, "Whoever wants to be first must be last of all and servant of all." Do you remember? Well, if you haven't heard it, I urge you to go and watch it on YouTube and see the past 2 weeks, because those 2 weeks build the foundation for today. Because the lesson continues. And it is not only important to know who Jesus is and how to lead a servant life. Today, Jesus reminds us that following Jesus is not about you, about me. It's not about the person, the self that is living or following Jesus. John comes to Jesus, as you heard, and says, "Hey, teach, we saw someone casting out demons in your name, and we tried to stop him because he was not following us." Did you catch that? He was not following us. What does Jesus answer? "Do not stop him. For no one who does a deed of power in my name will be able soon afterwards to speak evil of me. Whoever is not against us is for us." Jesus begins his reply to John with first person, for saying, "Whoever does a deed of power in my name," and then, so he starts off with the singular, first person singular, and completes his thoughts with first person plural, from me to we. Once again, he moves from me to we. Don't know if you've heard, Canada has once again a minority government. I am not a political guru, and I have no agenda whatsoever from this pulpit about any government. But I find it so interesting how the tone of our leaders have changed from being the best individual for Canada to, We will try to work together with the other parties. Have you noticed that? Right. They have moved from the me to the we. I just hope and pray that it is true, that they will work together. Friends, last week I asked, and I'm going to ask again, do you see the common theme, the thread, in the lessons of Jesus? Do you see the common thread that Jesus spoke to his disciples, his followers, ages ago, still applies to us today? Yes, 21st century, the words of Jesus are still alive and life-giving because they show us the way of an abundant life. You know, he kept on reminding his followers that he is not a worldly Messiah. He does not crave for fame and wealth. He doesn't say, how many followers do I have on Instagram? Right? And he invites everyone to this abundant life because in the abundant life we find hope, peace, joy, love, grace, mercy, righteousness, etc., etc. The list can go on. He calls everyone who is listening to him to be the least of society, like children, because in the realm of God, all are equal. All are servants to each other in the name of God. There is no one higher or lower. God says everyone is welcome. We may not be perfect, and I'll be the first to say this. Just the other day, I was leading our executive regional council meeting, and at the end I said, listen, I have no clue sometimes how this is going, but all I know that God has called me to this time and to this place. All I need to do is live through the perfect love of God. Not perfect. English is a second language, maybe even a fifth language. But what we do in the name of God's love, we go forward in that perfect love. Jesus calls everyone who follows him to radical hospitality, radical unity, radical generosity, radical inclusivity. I love the name of our denomination, United Church of Christ. But I prefer the name in Australia, the Uniting Church of Christ. Right? So we are United Church of Canada, uniting, because our unity is never completed. We are still uniting, uniting, uniting. So September 30th, Truth and Reconciliation Day. It's about time we have one, right? But do you remember why we needed one? Because of all the atrocities done to our indigenous sisters and brothers throughout history. Just like the disciples of Jesus, some bunch of Christian institutions thought that everyone must fit in the boxes that we have built. Everyone must speak the same language. Everyone should pray like we pray, eat like we do, wear same things, cut their hair. The other day I heard a young man who was having some bullying going on against him in school because he's a young indigenous boy that wants to leave his hair long and braided. So, but yet, we try to change others to be like us. Beloved, do you see how exclusive religion hurts the world? You've heard of extremists in the world, such as ISIS, and in recent months we've been hearing a lot once again about the Taliban in Afghanistan and other places. I hate to tell you, some Christians act just like those extremists. How many lives have ended in the name of religion? How many genocides has the world endured in the name of religion? Think about it. Maybe the Gospel of Mark is written ages ago, but it still applies to us today. Jesus is reminding his disciples and us, following Jesus is not about you. It's not about getting accolades, getting our way, but following Jesus is allowing the light of God spread through you. I find it so interesting. Here's a fun fact. Google is our new friend. Did you know that there are over 45,000 Christian denominations in the world? And we thought it was hard just the United Church to get along with another denomination. Right? 45,000. 2 billion Christians in the world and 45,000 different denominations. Separated just because one wanted to put the comma in their dogma here or the other one wanted to put it there. It is as simple as that. Sometimes the difference comes down to a comma in the theological differences. Beloved, I urge you to remember that the light we spread from this corner or anywhere you are present is the light of Christ. We are the mini lighthouses wherever we go. Second, I would like you to imagine, and if you want, close your eyes if you feel comfortable, but if you don't, that's okay, but imagine you are walking with Jesus so close that when the light, the sun, hits you, no one can see your silhouette, no one can see your shadow, but they can only see the silhouette of Jesus. Beloved, moving from me to we is a sign of discipleship that we are called for. You know, the three famous unholy trinity, me, myself, and I, does not exist in the realm of God. In the realm of God, selfishness dissolves into selflessness. Personal interests turn into communal care, compassion, and courage. In the realm of God, all man-made walls and rules and regulations crumble, and bridges of love and mercy are built. Beloved, when we work together in the name of Jesus, when we work together in the name of love, we do not criticize others. More importantly, we do not criticize ourselves looking for perfection, but we work together to eradicate poverty, feed the hungry, offer education to all boys and girls, advocate for justice, stand up in solidarity with those who are in the margins of life, and now more than ever, work together to end COVID. Doing our part, vaccinate, wear a mask, disinfect your hands regularly, and whatever else is required, let's just do it patiently and united. Not only following Jesus is not about me and you, but this life is not about me or you. It is all about making a difference in the world. I always say at every funeral, the dash between our birthday and our death is the most important part. We are called to come to this world and leave it better than we found it. Even if you touched one person's life, one, that is a huge difference. Remember the Good Shepherd? He went after the one lost sheep. Beloved, today my prayer is that we not only imagine a better world, but our actions move the entire world from the me to the we with love and inclusivity. With love and inclusivity. Thanks be to God. Amen.
Well, good morning, friends. Good to see you this morning. And I couldn't have asked for a better segue than our life lesson this morning that Takouhi shared with us. going from the me to the we, that's what mission and service is all about.
Awesome.
So, again, my name is Dave Charles, for those especially out in the Ethernet world somewhere. I'm the mission and service enthusiast for Grace United Church here in Gananoque. My role, along with many hundreds of other enthusiasts in United Churches across Canada, is to communicate how through your generosity and your hands-on work, we are making a difference in the lives of people around the world. Each week, we set aside roughly 5 minutes in worship to inform you of how mission and service resources are being applied and to help people both in the community and throughout the world. Also, what are the opportunities coming up that you could serve in any different way by seeing what other people are doing? Much of the time I have talked to you about the work done outside our local community, and you may have seen over the summer, etc. Quite often I get videos from the United Church to show something going on in Haiti or wherever. But recently I received some feedback, and I like to hear the feedback, that means you're paying attention, that you would like to hear more about how we're helping Gananoque and the surrounding communities. And yes, we are doing a lot. To that end, here's a summary of many, many things going on in your hometown and nearby. In 2020, financial support of $3,100 was provided by Grace to help families in need, the food bank, clothing programs, and Christmas for kids, along with other things which are too much for me to continue to list. And many of you might reflect back to Christmas. It's coming up pretty soon again, isn't it? Christmas funding provided 77 food hampers to the food bank, and our baby shower for Jesus, pointing to Nancy here, raised hundreds of dollars to support the Interval House for women and children in distress. Messy Church, which has unfortunately been suspended until we can keep these masks off with one another, is a monthly opportunity for us to share the love of Jesus to families and to children and supply fun and a hot meal, because some of these folks really don't get very much food, and it's nice that we can also provide that once a month. We continue to support the Gananoque Refugee Settlement Group. Sam McLeod has spoken here before, and we hope to have him back soon, and work with them, especially in light of the recent crises in Afghanistan, Haiti, Central America, and actually, if you go to the market, Lena, who's one of the refugee families who provides the Syrian food, was talking to Joan recently about, can we do a little bit more on some more people? We'll try, you know, we'll work through those agencies to see what we can do. United Church of Canada funding is used to support the education of our ministers and licensed lay worship leaders, such as our own Tammy over here. People may not know that, but some of the money goes to, for the teachers and the funding to provide all the Zoom meetings and whatever else you need to do that. Also, regional resources of $5,000 were used to help set up the audiovisual that you're seeing today. And you may have noticed some improvements. You're getting some close-ups now from different areas. And we're also saving the service on a much higher definition hard drive so that you'll be able to broadcast it later in better definition to Kojiko and others. So we feel that's a mission service outreach to everybody in the community and the broader church who may not be able to get to church. But also we're seeking further funding from the Eastern Ontario Regional Council of probably $5,000 this year and next year to continue to enhance it so that we'll have improvements to our sound and also perhaps have some screens in here that we can show videos of some of these mission service activities and other things. Many of the people at Grace United, many of them are here today and I thank you, have volunteered hundreds of hours of their time and support at local missions such as the Food Bank, the Salvation Army, which I understand is going to be opening fairly soon. They've got a new elevator in it. They're doing some nice things there. Seniors residences, the development of a community kitchen, and one-on-one care to our members and people in distress, which I think is one of the most important things, is people taking the time to just call one another and do a bit of a check to see how things are going. So as you can tell, I'm very enthusiastic about mission and service work in our community and around the world. Indeed, your generosity does make a big difference. Thank you for participating in mission and service.
Really makes a difference when we know a little bit more about what's going on, because the more we know each other, the more we get to love one another and encourage one another to make a difference. And part of our worship is the offertory that we bring to the glory of God. And because of COVID, we have a little offertory plates in the sanctuary. And those who are joining us virtually, you may go on our website and make a contribution for Grace United Church to continue the work of the living and the loving God, where the mission of God is the center of our being. So friends, let us continue and pray together the prayer of thanksgiving and dedication to all that we have received in the past and to all that we are receiving now and receiving in the future. So let us pray. Blessed be the Lord, for God is good, and God's love endures forever. Our Creator, help us to mirror your goodness through this offering in the world. Amen. Friends, as we prepare our hearts for the prayers of hope and healing, let us sing together, O Master, let me walk with thee. Amen and amen. Thank you, Paul. Friends, please join me in your hearts for prayers of hope and healing. And know that whatever is in your heart, all your joys and all your concerns, God has already answered them. Trust and let go. Let us pray. Holy One, Scripture promises us that the prayers of God's people are powerful and effective. And it is in this hope that we come to you today with our prayers. We pray, O God, first and foremost, that our prayers not be a to-do list to you, but our prayers may be promise on our side to partner up with you to make a difference. Today we bring to your throne of healing all who are sick and suffering, all who are in need of healing grace. May your spirit be evident, and may all know that they are not alone. We pray, O God, that you strengthen the doctors, nurses, and all caregivers. May their strength and wisdom multiply. And may we partner up with them to do our part to help fight this pandemic and many other illnesses together, united in love and respect, and still uniting. Today we pray for all who are fighting addictions in different forms and are burdened by guilt. Help us help others who are in these situations without our judgment or opinions, but be present with them with your love. Ruler of all the universe, we pray for all nations, from those who think they rule the world to the smallest nations who are poor and neglected. Help us help others. May your realm be known and your peace rule the world. We pray, O God, for the church that feels sometimes lost how to carry on. We long for your renewal. We long for the strength and the courage to build bridges of love that Jesus began 2,000 plus years ago. And may we get out of our comfort zones and with respectful boundaries, carry on the work, your mission here on earth. God of new life, raise us up in the power of the risen Lord, so that we may lift our hearts again and pray to you as our mother and our father, who art in heaven. Hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Beloved, even after we say amen to conclude our prayers, may our prayers never stop. May our prayers be our actions of seeking the way of Jesus, seeking the marginalized, and give them a helping hand. So today, let us sing together our song of going forth as a prayer. Make me a channel of your peace. Thank you. Beloved, go and build bridges and not walls. Bring peace wherever you go. Speak of God's news with your actions. If necessary, use words. And now may the Spirit of the Lord rest upon you. The word of the Lord live within and through you. And may the glory of the Lord shine upon you. This day and always, go in peace. Amen.